Tonight, which I like to call the before the break piece, and that's because it comes before the break. And if I can find it here, oh, here it is, okay, all right. Here's an article I found. The name of the article is called The Myth of 90%. Only a small fraction of guns in Mexico come from the U.S. You may be aware of the fact that Hillary Clinton the other day, a few days ago, laid a total blame for all the drug traffic that's coming in from Mexico on the United States. It's our problem, our fault. If we didn't have so many drug addicts in the United States, we wouldn't have all these problems, which is a typical liberal thing, a strategy of making an issue so that we can further regulate something. This article was written by William LaJeunesse and Maxim Lott from Fox News. It was dated Thursday, April 2nd, 2009. I'll read you the article. Part of the article here says, you've heard this shocking fact before on TV and radio and newspapers on the internet and from the highest politicians in the land. 90% of the weapons used to commit crimes in Mexico come from the United States. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton said it in reporters on a flight to Mexico City when she made her famous, now famous statement that the United States is the one responsible for all the drug trafficking coming into Mexico. Nothing to do with the Mexicans, it's just us. It's all our fault. Bob Schaefer referred to it while interviewing President Obama. Dianne Feinstein in a Senate hearing said it is unacceptable to have 90% of the guns that are picked up in Mexico and used to shoot judges, police officers, and mayors come from the United States. And William Hoover, the Assistant Director for Field Operations in the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms and Explosives, testified in the House of Representatives that there is more than enough evidence to indicate that over 90% of the firearms that have either been recovered in or interdicted in transport to Mexico, that means intercepted, I guess, originated from various sources within the United States. Now, it goes on to say in the article, there's just one problem with the 90% statistic, and it's a big one. It's just not true. In fact, it's not even close. The fact is only 17% of guns found at Mexican crime scenes have been traced to the U.S. While 90% of the guns traced to the U.S. actually originated in the United States, the percent traced to the U.S. is only about 17% of the total number of guns reaching Mexico. What's true, an ATF spokeswoman told FoxNews.com in a clarification of the statistic used by her own agency's assistant director, that's this Hoover guy, says that over 90% of the traced firearms originate from the U.S., but a large percentage of the guns recovered in Mexico do not get sent back to the U.S. for tracing because it is obvious from their markings they do not come from the U.S. Now, here's the comment. Here we find a great example of what spin is. This is how liberals spin things. They take a fact and they twist it into something that it isn't in order to create a situation that requires and then validates a proposed solution, which is always regulation. Regulation means laws, it means government intervention, government rules. Now, Clinton makes a statement in an attempt to politicize with foreign nations, kind of stroke them and make them know, okay, we're aware of the problem, and we're the problem, you're not the problem, we're the problem, and it gives them that political in, if you want to call it that. Schaefer, the news reporter from CBS, used it in an attempt to create an issue in order to cover it. That's what the news does. They create issues so that they have something to cover. Feinstein, obviously, as all liberal politicians, she mentioned it because she wants to portray herself as someone who's concerned, and concerned, again, translates into regulation. And Hoover, obviously, to give the impression that the ATF is on the job and they're aware of the issue. So these guys all have motivations for saying it. Now, here's the point. It says here that 90% of the guns that they attempt to trace as being from the U.S. are actually from the U.S. So that's where the 90% comes from. It's not that 90% of the guns found in Mexico come from the U.S. It's 90% of the guns that they attempt to trace as being from the U.S. are actually from the U.S. It says here that most of the guns they find, that means 83% of these guns they find have markings on them to indicate they're not from the U.S. They're from some other third world country, which proves that third world countries who have all these regulations and all these rules against carrying firearms are the big proponents of firearm sales. They're the ones with the black market. Countries like Russia, Mexico, a lot of the European countries, third world countries. And my whole point being, okay, Guatemala is one of them, the Mexican army, the people leave the service and they take the guns with them. Asia, South America, this is where all these guns come from. And these are all countries that are socialistic in nature and all try to regulate firearms. So it goes back to what the NRA says, and that is simply, when they outlaw guns, only outlaws will have guns. And the reason this is being done is there is an attack on the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment in the Constitution says that we have a right to bear arms. And so, as always, those who think they are doing good are doing nothing constructive and are only contributing to the undermining of the Constitution in this United States. And that's what we're going to be talking about for the next couple of months. These people who think they're doing stuff in the right, maybe have the good intentions, but are just doing nothing but damage. So, that's what I have to say about that. If you got something you want to say to me, you can contact me at right and wrong. I'm not right and wrong. We changed that email address. youidiot@rocketmail.com. And I got to go to my first break. When we come back, we're going to talk tonight about undermining a Republican. So just stay with us right here on KTSTFM.com. We'll be right back.